हेलो एवरीबॉडी, हाउ आर यू? यू आर फाइन? ओके. इन लास्ट पीरियड वी स्टडीड द पोएम पास्ट प्रेजेंट फ्यूचर. वी स्टडीड. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इंग्लिश वर्कशॉप. ओके. इन इंग्लिश वर्कशॉप नंबर वन, रीड द पोएम अलाउड यूजिंग प्रॉपर रिदम एंड इंटोनेशन. मीन्स यू हैव टू रीड द पोएम. ओके. हाउ? विथ रिदम एंड इंटोनेशन. नाउ सेकंड हियर क्वेश्चन इज हियर, लिंक द एटम्स इन द थ्री कॉलम्स प्रॉपरली. इन ए कॉलम, बी कॉलम एंड इन सी कॉलम. इन ए कॉलम the past, the present, our and the future, it is given in a column. You have to match them with B and C. With B and C. In B, a sea beneath a cloudless sun, a soft and mild autumn evening, a green and flowery spray where a young bud sits. In C column, a pleasant time which has ended. An excited, thrilling time which has no end. A time full of life in which you gather strength. You have to match, you have to link. And by linking, you have to complete this. Third question is here given. Find the meaning of the following words. The, mournfully, spray and mighty. You have to find their meanings from the dictionary. Write the adjectives that are used to describe the following. Evening, spray, sea. Adjectives you have to write. Means, one example I can give you. Boy. Boy is the noun. Which adjective will you use for the boy? Smart boy. Smart is adjective. Okay. Now, day. For day, which adjective will you use? Beautiful day. Here, beautiful is adjective. Likewise, you have to use adjectives. Evening, spray, sea. Okay. Next question is given here, fifth one. Write one line about each of the following with the help of the poem. You have to read the poem. Following lines are given. Wind in the autumn evening. Then young bird on the spray. Then the sea. For this, you have to find the correct line from the poem. Read the poem and find the poem for these lines. Okay. You complete this activity at home. Another activity is given here, language study. You write that language study also at home. I will read that language study. A simile is an imaginative comparison of two different things which have something in common. A simile always includes the words as or like. For example, as tall as tree, as lovely as flower. Simile, it is a figure of speech. For making a simile, as or like, these words are used. As black, as coal, as clear, as crystal. These are the examples of simile. Or she fights like warrior. Like is here word which is used for simile. Another here figure of speech is given here. Metaphor. Metaphor is an imaginative expression that refers to someone or something as another person thing. Metaphor is also figure of speech. And for something or some imaginative expression it is, which is used for other person or thing. It shows that the person or thing has some quality of that person or thing. Means the word as or like are not used. Means here are or as, these words are not used. If you use them, then it will become simile. So without using them, we have to use, you have to make its figure of speech. Example is given here. He is a gem of person. He is a gem of person. Here gem is the word which is compared with he. Okay, another example is given here. Time is money. Another example is here, books are our friends. The clouds are white sheep. Okay. Or he is Sachin Tendulkar in cricket. Like this. These are the examples of metaphors in the poem. Can you find them from the poem? You find and tell me. Okay. You complete this English workshop at home. Complete the homework and show me. Send me images of homework. Some students are not sending. Okay. Send me images so that I will understand that you are completing homework or not. For today, this is enough. Okay. Bye-bye.